Dear dreamers, welcome back to Emiya Soleil Dreamwork. Many say it's important to forgive, the most important thing than anything else. And by forgiving, one will be free from pain, it said. People who have been through severe trauma caused by others, abused, as in beaten or raped, or in having their loved one murdered, and so on, would be delivered if just forgiving those who have done them wrong, it said. But is this true? Well, the one who have been through trauma has been wounded, and as long as the pain is there and the wound has not been cared for, the pain will be inflamed. And when the wound is healed, the scar will always remind of the trauma, but it will for sure fade in time. But when someone else has caused the trauma, it takes an inner process to be able to heal and to be able to trust again. Nothing can hasten this. It has to take time. Feeling more whole again is necessary to be able to forgive. Not the other way around. Forgiveness rises always from inside. But if forgiving actually is releasing pain and helps letting go of bad memories, someone may ask, wouldn't forgiving be the best thing to do? And what about the ones being forgiven? Are the best for them not to be able to move on from guilt? Well, actually, the most important thing for the one who have caused the trauma and pain to someone else is to feel the need to ask for forgiveness. Not just uttering the words, not just wanting to already be forgiven, but to feel the urge to ask for forgiveness. Because then the words, please forgive me, contains the will to change. This is just as important as forgiving, and even more since the inner process of wanting to change because of remorse is an initiation transformation. Repentance is not meant as a punishment, and it's nothing like repeating prayers or something like that. It's reflecting and learning, the will to grow and to be more loving again against others. It's a cause and effect in the way that it's meant to be, learning by mistakes. When it comes to forgiving, it's not an act of will, not ever. It's not a mental decision directly leading to be able to forgive someone. And on the other hand, around not being able to forgive is not like holding a grudge towards someone or not like wanting to avenge something. And when it comes to forgiving, time is crucial. Anger, grieving, pain have to be allowed before accepting. And accepting is the first goal in the process. Accepting as in this has happened and not as in I'm okay with this. Allowing oneself to feel whatever comes up from inside leads to accepting. Accepting does not come first, of course, because shock does, then emotional and physical reactions, then acceptance, the first goal. And in the time after processing comes perhaps forgiving. There's nothing negative though from not being able to forgive in the first place, only from not being able to accept in the long run, because when not being able to accept, one will still be stuck in the trauma. And the most negative thing is this, if feeling forced to be good or enlightened as a person who forgives unconditionally, thereby suppressing feelings that are needed to be expressed and accepted. It means not allowing oneself to process and heal properly. Besides, it's martyrdom and nothing positive ever comes from that. Look at Christianity, the thought of a descended, enlightened person being dying in pain because humanity is such an impossible bunch of sinners doesn't change nothing at all. People are still stuck in duality until we feel the inner urge to change to the better, to to be true to our consciences. The inner process is the key there too, of course. Becoming a better person is an act of something else than pure will, because certainly not it's coming from guilt stemming up from martyrdom. I don't say it's impossible to forgive, but being able to forgive or not has become kind of a measuring stick, hinting to who is more spiritually advanced than another, and forgiving is no competition. It's a possible outcome of an inner and often long process. And remember, accepting is far more important. Well, someone perhaps is thinking, are we not able to decide what to feel and what to think? Isn't this the time when thoughts manifest themselves? Yes, but there's a huge difference between true feelings and mental constructions. And if something is not ready under the surface, the result will take form in shape of that, and we will keep on feeling and also attracting pain. Once upon a time, some decades ago, I in despair did a guided forgiveness process to be able to free myself from quite a negative situation. I put a lot of willpower in it, and I even felt strong love towards the person I wanted to forgive in order to be able to let go. At least that was what I thought. What happened? That I attracted the same negative situation over and over again, even if I stepped out of the actual situation. Under the surface lurked fear, rage, shame, guilt, and that kind of emotions opened up to the same pattern to come to me again, because I really needed to work on the wound. And even if I had left the situation hadn't left me. Not at all. Even if I tried to convince myself that I'd had forgiven and I really, really loved my antagonist. It wasn't until I did the shamanic work to come closer to my wound I could begin to free myself from the pattern of being a victim in certain situations. And I'm convinced of that I had not wrongly thought that I was... that if I had not wrongly thought that I was obligated to be a totally forgiving person, always loving others more than myself, it would have been easier. Not that the shamanic work was something I regret doing, no, quite the opposite. It gave me quite a really wonderful awakening, although it was quite harsh. My self-confidence was there in form of a strong wolf in the process. It's a wolf that I had met in dreams, but now I met it deadly wounded. It was dying, and when running for my life with my dying self-confidence in my arms, just to find out it was too late. I learned to never do that to myself again. The wolf anyhow came back in dreams, and although I had to work hard to earn its trust anew, and I really had to heal it in many dreams, I knew that we were one. The wolf is a part of me, and it roars when I find myself in situations where I tend to walk into that old pattern of mine. So when dreams do their work, and we let them without illusions of being a good person the wrong way, which means sacrificing oneself in a negative way, the process of accepting trauma and healing wounds can work its way towards forgiving. The wrongdoings in the past, as long as back in the childhood, can suddenly show itself being worked through by the subconscious. In one of my old dreams, I found myself in such a situation. I was back in my early childhood's house, along with the persons living then, and also present with a visitor who was a person who had hurt me when I was a young child. A man I consequently had avoided thinking about a huge part of my life. But the subconscious had done the work, and in the dream I understood earlier dreams I had on this team and how they helped me feel what I have locked away. And in the actual dream, I stepped up to the person and I gave him my golden heart that I was wearing around my neck, and then I hugged him. When I woke up, I was surprised over the fact that I had forgiven without even putting effort to it. I had no shame left, no anger, and no fear, and I felt free. The fact that it was 40 years later wasn't important, since time really is needed in these processes. The interesting thing is that the dream, when we looked into each other's eyes, the other person and I, when initially finding ourselves standing on the same floor for the first time for I don't know how long, I saw not only that he was as surprised as I was, but there was this insecure gaze he gave me, not shameful, but insecure, as in this question, will you forgive me? I'm certain that what happened so long ago had haunted this person too, at least in an unconscious realm, and there lies the need to ask for forgiveness, not to automatically be forgiven without effort, but show the person one have done wrong regret. I know the difference because when I was a teenager, I once said some quite hurting things to a girl because of jealousy. I didn't know her so well, and when I almost immediately started to feel very bad about my unfair words, I had no clue about where to find her. I really, really wished to meet her so I could tell her how sorry I was. I really felt regret, and I wanted to correct my wrongdoing. Fortunately, I met her just as coincidentally that as the last time, and when she turned her head the other way to avoid me, I walked towards her and I put my hand on her shoulder and I told her how very sorry I was for acting like I did, that I what I said was wrong. She didn't say that she forgave me, but she only said okay, and actually that was quite all right, because I didn't tell her that I was sorry in order to be forgiven. I just wanted her to know that I felt regret about my actions, that I did wrong. And the urge inside me was strong. The point is that she for sure needed time to forgive. And even if she did forgive me, she didn't have to, because she just had to accept what had happened. And in time, I'm pretty sure that she did, and that she released herself from the impact my words had on her young self. Also, of course, I have forgiven myself for acting this way. This is very important too. It took a while, because even if I had told her I was really sorry, I kept regretting what I'd done until I forgave myself. Understanding my insecure, immature self, wanting to have my ex-boyfriend to myself, mourning my loss of me forever. Yeah, I know, but teenagers are not quite in control of the synapses. So the next time you meet the concept of releasing pain by evoking a feeling of forgiving, think about it. What is forgiving? Where does it come from? Close your eyes and feel. What is there beyond the surface of your willingness to forgive? Your willingness to be a kind-hearted and loving person, let go of pain. Is there a natural feeling of letting go, or is there a struggling with the feeling? There is no judging here in my words, only another way to approach the healing of traumas and wounds. Be kind to yourself and do not demand impossible things that the wounded part of yourself can't work with. Instead, let the process take its time. Give yourself that time in order to heal. Besides, being unconditionally loving as a person means being both severe and kind. It means being in balance. It does not mean forgiving everything without saying no and without feeling and expressing emotions of rage and sorrow. Being in balance doesn't mean mastering emotions as in condemning them into silence and instead showing a smiling, happy face. Balance means working with everything inside until it's transformed into a fertilizing fuel. So that was all for today. Bless you all. Much love to you, and we'll see each other soon again. Bye bye.